Hey guys, what's up? PimArthur here, and welcome back to Let's Play Mario Kart 8. In the last episode, we went through the final cup of the game, which was the Lightning Cup. So in this episode, I went back and got the 3-star rank on Flower Cup. Wasn't hard to do at all. I just got first on every race and got, you know, a fair amount of coins at the end of each race, and, you know, combined with that, I got it. So we're going to move on to 100cc. Now, there actually is something I want to show very quickly. I'm going to go back for a second. Just something to note, if you wait around on this screen long enough for Mario to go through all three laps, the little cutscene here actually freezes for a second, and I'm not going to wait around for it, but just something kind of interesting to note, because I was busy getting this all set up, and that apparently happened. We'll play as Wario, and we have the Cloud Glider. Now, off screen, I did not do any races. I did do a lot of battle stuff with my friends to see how it worked, so we did pick up coins in that, so I do have a lot of other stuff now, customization-wise, so if you see any extra stuff, then that would be why. I'm trying to find something with a decent amount of speed and traction here. Those have pretty good traction. I'm just going to go with the basic glider here. The Excel on this is a little low. Actually, I think I'll go with a different one. This one's got better Excel, so I'll take this. And we're just going to head on back to Mushroom. Initially, I was going to wait for a little while, but I can't stop myself from playing this game. I have to keep going. I need to know how much the difficulty goes up by. I mean, 100 should still be fairly easy to, you know, complete, but who knows. But I mean, yeah, we've gone through everything, and I have to say that I am, you know, I approve of what the game has to offer. It's done really well in all aspects. At the time this is being recorded, I had the first video up. Mushroom Cup 50cc has been up. Flower Cup is actually rendering right now, so that one will be up tomorrow. But I'm recording this on the 31st, so it's the day after the launch. It's kind of disappointing that I was only able to get the first video up today and not the day of it launching, but the processing took so long for HDMI, and I knew it was going to take a while, but I wasn't expecting it to take that long, so that's why I wasn't able to get it, so I'm sorry for anybody that wanted to be out the day, you know, it came out because I wanted it to go to my channel too, but it just didn't happen, so I do apologize for it, but there's, you know, what can you do? At the same time, I know some people probably won't want to watch the Let's Play if you are trying to avoid, like, spoilers on the game and, you know, have been up to this point, but, I mean, you know, I couldn't help but do it. I did it with, there was another game that I actually did a Let's Play for when it came out, or very close to when it came out, and it was Mario Party 9. And, you know, we already know about Mario Party 9, it's not the best in the series, let's put it that way. But this one's a lot better when it comes to new ones. You know, when it comes to new Mario Karts, I hold my expectations up to the expectations of Double Dash, which is my favorite one. And I do the same thing for Smash Bros. As I hold my expectations up to where Melee is, because I played Melee yesterday with my friends, and it's still fantastic to play. And I had forgotten how good the game was, and it's, you know, relatively old, and I still think it's a fantastic game. And I know it's not the best idea to hold your expectations up to another game, but, you know, you do want to be impressed by whatever they make, and I am impressed by this. You don't want to be like, you know, if they make a bad game, they make a bad game. They have duds every once in a while. You want every game that they make to be a good game. Because otherwise you wouldn't want to get them. Well, that still is incredibly difficult. I do like the speed increase, though. It felt a lot less, you know, let's look around at the area. I mean, we can view the highlight reel very quickly, but there's not going to be much on it. That was a battle I did as I hit Daisy with that red shell. And then I just kind of got the lead and never lost it after that.
Whoa!
I am starting to get the boost figured out. The boost is not quite, as I said earlier, I said it was like right after the 2 goes away. It's not quite that late. You can do it a little bit earlier. That is Rosalina, baby Rosalina. Oh, come on. We can do it, Wario. Well done, Wario. We've taken the lead. It was funny though, ever since I put up that first video, and keep in mind the first video was literally just Mushroom Cup 50cc, that wasn't it. Somebody was like, you need to stop abusing Waluigi so much. So apparently using Waluigi once in a race is abusing a character now. People's comments are funny to watch. Oh, come on. That's not what I want to see. Haha, you deserve that. That's what I've noticed too, it's also easier to get mushrooms in this game. Like, even if you're in a fairly high position, you still seem to get them. There was one race that I played with my friends where I got a mushroom and I was in first. And it was a four-player race and we had computer players, so I mean, it was still the same amount of racers as you're seeing right here. Just, it was multiplayer instead of single player, so it's kind of strange. We're kind of going back to Mario Kart 64, how you could get, you know, really good items even if you were in a lower position. Or in a higher position, I guess. Because you could get, like, lightning in second place, which I don't expect they'd go that far, but... Even so. So hopefully everybody is doing alright today. Hopefully you're enjoying Mario Kart 8 or not. You can tell me what you've been playing recently. Aw, poor Luigi. He's in last. I'm gonna ignore the highlight reels from now on, because originally it was just kind of to show him off. Unless something really cool happens, I'm gonna ignore them. Which sometimes really cool stuff does happen, but, I mean, if nothing happens that I consider worth rewatching, which, you know, most of the races probably will be that way from now on, then I will probably ignore it. Ah, Daisy, you stole both of the item boxes that I wanted. So in other news, Pokemon has officially trademarked the name Pokemon Delta Emerald now. You know how we have Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, the remakes Ruby and Sapphire coming out soon. They've taken the trademark for Delta Emerald. They have not confirmed a release for it, but they have taken the trademark for it, so... I might actually be getting my name on a Pokemon game. Which is funny, because I joked about that with other people. I was like, they've got Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, maybe they'll have a Delta Emerald, and then, like, a couple days after that, they trademark it. Stupid fire flowers. Getting out of here before they hit one of me, or one of them hits me. Oh. I am kind of running behind the group that I need to be. Let's take the blue path. Hang on to this. Now the fire flower you can pretty much... Oh, come on. Really? I was going to say you could spam it and then some jerk spammed the lightning. The drafting is still in this game too, where, not drifting, drafting, it is a different thing. It's a technique where two or more cars can go faster. If basically, if you get behind somebody, and Mario Kart, we had this too, if you get behind somebody and for long enough, you'll actually get a boost to speed from them, because it's restricting the, it's doing something to the airflow, and I'm not going to go into the details of it. But basically, if you stay behind somebody long enough, it'll actually let your car go faster for a short amount of time. Go. Stay away from that banana peel. And we're good. The nice thing about being a heavyweight is when it comes to top speed, it's really hard for people to catch you. It's one of the things you kind of have to watch out for. Like I said, generally speaking, the people that are accustomed to the racing games pick heavier engine classes because of that, because while they have a lower acceleration, their top speed overall is faster, so. And I haven't been online yet, but like I said, I'm willing to bet that most people, whenever they get practice to it, will take the bikes, and they'll take heavyweights or middleweight characters. I think that's what we should expect to see. Or have seen already, maybe some of you guys have been playing it as well. There might be a couple people that ask for my ideas so they can play, you know, the game with or slash against me. I'm not going to give it out right now. I probably will later, but not right now. Maybe at near the end of the project or after the Grand Prix or whatever. Mario, you don't have to take all the coins, dude. Something interesting about the bombs, I noticed while we were playing versus mode or the battle mode, is that the bombs, whenever you deploy them, whether you throw them forward or backward, they actually walk around. They move a little bit. Have fun with that, Mario. Pretty sure he fell off the stage. Yep, he did fall off the stage. See what I mean? I mean, I can just catch up to these lightweight characters because their top speed's so low. That right there was the drafting right there where I got that boost to speed. That's what it was. No, thank you. You can keep the shell. A lot of the, not the trailers, but a lot of the reviews for this game, like the online reviews by, you know, whatever website it is, seem to say that they really like this level, and I have to agree, it's a pretty good level. This is probably the one level of Mushroom Cup that's not really that boring, because, like I said, I feel like this one was a little bit more boring, but it was because we're playing it on 50cc. It does feel better now that I'm not playing it on such a low engine class. Which I guess to some people, 100 might still be low, but, you know, it's not as low as 50. I'll hang on to the shell just in case something should pop up. I'm not going to bother taking that little shortcut ramp right there. I think that will get better, like, I'll get used to that shortcut over time, but it is one that's very easy to miss. I don't know if that was Wario's victory jump right there, or if I actually legitimately hit somebody with that shell. Kinda wanna see if that's the case, but probably not. Let's check the highlight reel. Yeah, that totally hit Mario off the side right there. You can see him falling to his death. Watch him fall to his death in slow motion. Oh well. He'll survive. Lakitu's a lot faster picking you up, too, off the edge of the stage, and I do like that as well, because in the old ones, oh man, you get that little annoying noise where it's like, ear, 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 and it would be for about, like, 3 seconds. Which, in racing time, is a lot. No, I'm not going to post that to Miiverse. Thank you for asking that. Quite nice of you. But in case anybody was wondering what game, because for those of you that don't know, and hopefully most of you do, now that we're in a new video, I'm just gonna go ahead and say this now. Let's see who we got. Lemmy. We'll use Lemmy. Why not? He looks so happy. I need a car with more speed, though. That and that. Anyway, I got distracted by picking my car. Now that we are back with some more of, well, you know what? That one's pretty short because it doesn't take as long to race. So we'll probably have two cups in this video. So forget what I just said about being in a new video. We got plenty of time here. We're only like 15 minutes, so. But anyway, in case anybody was wondering, because for those of you that don't know, using the password for the Nintendo shop in this, that they give you, you can actually purchase one of, or not purchase, but you can get another game for free in addition to this one. And you can choose between Mario U, Super Mario Bros. U, The Legend of Zelda Wind Waker HD, Wii Party U, and Pikmin 3. The one that I ended up getting was Wii Party U. The reason being is because I already own Wind Waker and I really don't care if it's an HD or not. I'm not going to be a fan of the game either way, personally. Because I just don't like Wind Waker. We've been over this before. I already own Mario Bros. U. I owned a copy of Mario & Luigi U. It came with my Wii, so there was no point in buying that one. And Pikmin 3, honestly, I haven't gotten into Pikmin 2 at all. So I feel like it would be kind of hard for me to get into Pikmin 3. But who knows? Pikmin 3 might be really good. I liked Pikmin 1 a lot, which is why I did the Let's Play on it. Pikmin 2, I'm kind of iffy on. And if people could stop targeting you with shells, I would really appreciate it. Good, you deserved it. However, I will mention currently right now, and I know there's been a lot of issues. In fact, there's a website that reported it, and I had a lot of trouble with it as well. Because so many people have gotten this game. At least at this current point in time, it's probably changed by the time this video is going up, but like the first couple days that it went up, a lot of people were logging on to that, like, you know, making new accounts and whatever, and there were so many that it was messing up the server. So if you had trouble getting in the first couple of days, that would be why. You have until, according to the requirement time, you have until July 31st to pick up the game, so you've got plenty of extra time, but just note that if you had trouble logging into the Nintendo shop, then that was why. Now, for those of you that have never used the Nintendo shop, the points that or the coins that they give you are for registering your consoles, and also for registering some, you know, the things that come in your games. So if you don't want to buy any of the four games that I mentioned, or get them for free, that is, then you can just save the coins and, you know, save it up for something else that you might want. But any game that you have that has, like, a, you know, a little Club Nintendo thing, you can register that, and in addition, you can also register your 3DS and your Wii U. And you can look on the actual website for, you know, how to do that. And no, I did not get asked by them to say that or anything. Just letting you know that there is a free game that you can, you know, obtain. And since you already bought this game, you might as well pick up another one, right? But like I said, if none of those interest you, you don't have to get that. You can easily just save your coins for something else that you might want that's actually on there. But the reason I bought Wii Party U is because one of my friends already owns it. I knew that it, you know, it was going to be a good game. I knew exactly what to expect. I'd played it a lot with him and a lot of, with also other players. I knew what to expect from it. I knew I wanted to do a Let's Play on it at some point, so I was going to pick it up regardless. So now that it's actually on my Wii U as opposed to, you know, having it, you know, like on a CD, I know that I'll have it no matter where, you know, I take the Wii U. I won't have to worry about bringing the disc or anything. I'll just have it on here. Next this. But Wii Party U, if you liked Wii Party, you're probably gonna like Wii Party U. Wii Party U's got a very interesting mode called Mii Fashion Plaza, where basically you go around a very small board and there's like different kinds of outfits you can make. There's like there'll be a cowboy outfit, a ninja outfit, a pirate outfit. There's like a caveman outfit, a space outfit, a Mario outfit, and you'll pick up different parts of it, like, depending on what space you land on. You might get the Mario hat, but you still need the Mario shoes and the Mario overalls. And then once you make a full outfit, you try to get back to the, you know, the space you started on. And then you get points based on your costume and each piece of clothing. Okay, seriously, guys, you don't have to target me every single time. There we go. Finally. Let's grab these. But if you can make it, manage to make a full costume, like a complete set, like all the Mario pieces or all the Spaceman pieces or whatever, it'll double the points for your outfit. And then there's also mini games you can play to, like, you know, play to steal from somebody else. Or you'll play a four-player game, and whoever gets first gets to pick anything they want. Second place gets an item out of a set that they choose. The third person place person gets an item at random, and then fourth doesn't get anything. So just little things like that, but it's a very fun game to play, and it's, you know, it's kind of funny when you get, like, a really messed up outfit that doesn't have any matching parts whatsoever. So you have, like, a cowboy hat, the Mario overalls, and, like, clown shoes or something ridiculous like that. But a lot of people like that one, so I think Wii Party U did a good job. I think it's interesting that people, like, the ratings that they put minigames, because people can rate the minigames, it seems like a lot of the good ones were overlooked, like the ones that I liked anyway. It was nice to see, though, that most of the luck-based ones were at the back of the pack on what people liked and disliked. A lot of people didn't like the luck-based ones, which I understand that completely, because I always go by the motto, the better you are at a game, the more you don't want to see a luck-based game appear. Because you know that you're less likely to win it. If you've had no experience, then the luck-based games are exactly what you want to see, because you know that hopefully everybody has a fair chance at winning. And it has nothing to do with experience. That is a nice little strategy right there to avoid the shells, is to get up next to that wall. Which, that's a good strategy for all the Mario Karts, so. You know, initially I thought that I wasn't really going to like the Koopalings, but I actually really do like using them. I think it was a bizarre choice to put them in, but I do like using them, so. Maybe my thoughts about Pink Gold Peach will, you know, disappear once I actually unlock her. But we'll see. I haven't got Metal Mario yet, so let's pick a side and commit. Thank you. Now here's actually an interesting tidbit, now that I thought about it. When I was racing on Versus, whenever I jumped on one of those ramps, I actually landed on top of the trolley. And if you do that, it actually boosts you again. So just another thing to make note of. If you've got the opportunity for it, try to land on top, because you get another boost, and it will bounce you fairly high, but it will give you a boost as well, like an additional one. I did it completely by accident, but, you know, just something to make note of. Already figuring out pro strategies for Mario Kart Tournament 2015. Or something. I don't know. Hello, my boo buddies. I missed you. Seriously, though, whatever happened to using the boo item in this game? Like, it used to be around, and then, like, it was around in Mario Kart Super Circuit, it was in Super Mario Kart, it was in Mario Kart 64, but after that, we really never saw it. It was really only those first three Mario Karts that it appeared, and then we never really saw it after that. Seemingly vanished. I mean, we got King Boo as a character, but I liked the Boo item. It was a really nice item to have. I think the issue that most people probably have with it is the fact you could get it even if you were in a really high place, and because of that, you know, depending on what you stole, you could have a star in first place or something really good in first place. I think that's what people didn't like, but if you set it to where you can only get it in, like, fourth or lower, it probably wouldn't be that big a deal. Maybe it's just people don't like getting their items stolen, but, you know, that's what the boo item does. It doesn't have a hidden agenda. You know exactly what you're going to get from using it. But either way, just kind of an interesting note that you haven't seen it since the third Mario Kart game. Because in case anybody doesn't know the order, Super Mario Kart was first, followed by Mario Kart 64, And then Super Circuit came out in 01. So Super Circuit is after Mario Kart 64, not before it. Which I kind of figured that was the case, but, you know, wasn't 100% sure. Avoid the banana peel. Here you go. But say, that had better not been meant for me. DK, knock it off. I'm letting you pass. Okay, seriously guys, you don't have to keep running into me. I am probably not going to get first place on this race. Interesting note though too, is also if you're playing battle, you remember how you used to be able to camp, like, where the item boxes were, where you could just keep getting the same item box over and over every time it spawned? They actually made it to where now, if you want to get the same item box, you have to back up a little bit or move forward a little bit to a certain point where, just a certain point where it will respawn. You can't just stand on that same spot and have the item box reappear every single time. It won't do that anymore, so. Just an interesting thing to make note of. Aw, you jerks. Right at the finish line, too, and that I'm going to get in third place because of them. That's ridiculous. Almost fourth, and then right after that, the acceleration just quits on this car for whatever reason. And it was Donkey Kong again. What a surprise, Emil. Stupid banana peel. No! Target somebody else. Of course! Gonna take my coins back. No, I'm letting you pass me. I'm letting you pass me! Jeez. Even the AI seems to know, like, whenever they have a star, instead of just you'll move over to let them pass you, but they'll still target you anyway. It's annoying. I do like the Piranha Plant item. This is probably one of my favorite items that they've had this far. Bye. Bye. Kind of surprised that bomb didn't get anybody. I still say those guys sound, they remind me of Seesaw from Rhythm Heaven Fever. It's not quite the same principle, but it's still, you know, funny. I would do a Let's Play on Rhythm Heaven Fever, but you can't really do a Let's Play on that and have commentary, because you're supposed to be focusing on the beat, for those of you that have not played that game. It's all about, like, the beats of the songs and the timing of when you have to hit the button. So it'd be kind of hard to commentate over that unless you post-commentate it, and then if you did that, then if people are using it to try to figure out how to get the timing down, then they can't hear the song because you're talking over it, so. It's kind of a hard thing to balance out for that. You kind of have to do it with no commentary, really. I I'm gonna save this in case the shell comes. Well, would you look at that? A red shell. Can't imagine who threw that. Alright, let's see. Let me guess, one star, right? One star or an A. Nope, one star. What is it with the flower cup and me not doing well on it? Oh well. Well, I am gonna end this off here because we're at 31 minutes, so. See you guys next time for 100cc on Star and Special Cup. Peach. Oh, speaking of Pink Gold Peach, there she is, right there. I guess I will give her a try, because I gotta go get that 3-star off screen, so I will do that. And see you guys in the next episode.